And hello everyone, and on the eve of the Olympics, I decided to make a video for those who have been following gymnastics for not so long and do not understand many words and slang in rhythmic gymnastics. Although it's possible that those who are doing rhythmic gymnastics do not know the meaning of some words, so this video is the top that you need to share with everyone and immerse yourself in the professional language of gymnastics. I'm sure that this video will be useful for many, and perhaps I will not touch on all the words that raise questions from my viewers, but according to the tradition of our videos, you can write in the comments and I will either do the second part, or those who will come to watch the video will continue to expand their gymnastics vocabulary by reading comments. Well, before you start watching the video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so yet. The subscribe button should be grey. This is very important for me. Well, by following the link in the description, you can support what I do with donation. It will be more pleasant for me. Thank you. Well, let's go to the main terms, slings, and words from the world of rhythmic gymnastics. I should probably make a reservation that I will not give the official definitions, but I will try to make it clear to people who are not related to gymnastics. I will explain it in the simplest possible language. I hope it will work out. If you still have questions, I will definitely answer in the comments. The word FIG stands for Fédération Internationale de Gymnastique. In English, it's International Gymnastics Federation. The current president is Morinari Watanabe. The federation includes far more than one rhythmic gymnastics. At the moment, there are six gymnastic disciplines listed here. The federation develops competition rules, resolve conflicts, and other important things. In fact, this is the most important instance for gymnasts. Each country has its own federation, which is responsible for actions in its own country. For example, in Russia, it is Russian Rhythmic Federation, or abbreviated as VFAG. Often during the competition, I use such word as qualification. For those who are connected with sports, of course, it's understandable, but there are also those who do not understand its meaning. For rhythmic gymnastics, qualification is the qualifying stage of the competition. Usually, medals are not awarded in the qualification, but a certain number of athletes are selected, and this athletes will compete for medals. For example, in the all-round in gymnastics, it is also called all-round. It's when gymnasts perform with all four apparatus for individual and with two apparatus for group teams, and according to the sum of this exercise, medals are awarded. This is considered as the most important medal, and it is also called Olympic medal, since only this medal will be awarded for rhythmic gymnastics at the Olympics. In addition to the all-round, there are finals of individual apparatus. Here, I think everything is logical. Gymnasts are awarded for medals in each apparatus separately and usually get to these finals according to the results of the qualification. Pinwheel. The word is quite incomprehensible if you are not connected with the gymnastics. During the competition, gymnasts can perform on the pinwheel. In this case, it will be clear to explain that with an example. If the girls perform on the pinwheel with four apparatus in one day, then the first gymnast comes out with a hoop, the next with a ball, the third with the collapse, the fourth with a ribbon, and the fifth again comes out with a hoop. When the flow ends and the gymnast move on to the performances of the second apparatus, the first gymnast who performed with a hoop now comes out with a ball, and the next gymnast who performed with a ball comes out with a collapse. Usually, I think it's clearer. Well, when the girls perform with two apparatus on the pinwheel, the apparatus simply alternates. So the first comes out with a hoop, the second with a ball, the third again with a hoop, and so on. There are several divisions in rhythmic gymnastic competition. We will also touch on this. In general, this is the Olympic Games, the World Championship, Continental Championships, for example, European Championship, the Asian Championship, the Oceania Championship, Pan American Championship, and the African Championship. Also, stages of the World Cup, Challenge Cup, Grand Prix, European Games, Universiades, international tournaments, and then various championships of countries, districts, regions, and cities. In competition, most often everything depends on the regulations. It can be changed at least every year, so I will not explain this in detail. I basically do this in the reports from competition, what kind of start it is and how important it is, but the details need to be explained. International tournaments, depending on the rules of the competition, any gymnast can participate here, or there are restrictions on participation from country. The most important start in the world of gymnastics is the World Cup stage, or the World Cup. This is the series of competition which is organized and established by the regulation of FIG. Something that doesn't change is that the gymnast pass each tournament and earn points that are usually summed and awarded additionally according to the results of the four competitions. The next is Grand Prix Series, is a tournament for the strongest gymnast of the international class. The Universiade is a competition for students. The Challenge Cup is similar to the World Cup, but it is considered as more extensive, so more gymnasts and more countries can come to it. There are fewer restrictions on participation. Terrible words related to competition are doping and protest. Doping is a prohibited drug. They are more often used to help the body. They are not abused in gymnastics, but there are plenty of stories with doping disqualification in gymnastics. All prohibited drugs are fixed in a special document, which is sometimes updated. A protest in gymnastics is when a coach submits a document that challenges the gymnast's scores. You can file a protest only on the assessment of the difficulty of the body or apparatus and only your gymnast. A protest is a paid pleasure. If the protest is accepted, then you don't need to pay. With each new protest at the competition, its price increases. If the coach decides to file a protest, they must do it until the next competition is evaluated. Now, a little bit about the categories and how the gymnasts are called. In ripping gymnastics, in Russia and other post-Soviet countries, there are the first, the second, and the third categories for both adults and youth. Gymnasts can perform according to the CMS, which stands for Candidate in Master of Sports, or according to the MS, which means the Master of Sports. To assign categories to gymnasts, there is the MSMC, which stands for Master of Sports of International Class. Also, there is ZMS, which in Russian means Honored Master of Sports. The criteria for performing the titles are fixed in the documents, and some of them change periodically. During the competition, we often meet such words as pre-juniors, juniors, and seniors. More often, we meet such words at the international tournaments, since there is no categorical system everywhere in the world as in Russia. Senior gymnasts are gymnasts who perform according to the program of Master of Sports. Usually, they are age 16 or older. Juniors are the same as the program of candidates in the Master of Sports. There are usually gymnasts of 13 to 15 years old. Pre-juniors are like the first adult category, and the gymnasts of 11 to 12 years old perform here. Depending on the competition, these names can also be modified. Individuals and groups are the words that are commonly used in rhythmic gymnastics. The individual program is when a gymnast performs alone on the carpet. The group program at the moment consists of 5 people, but there were times when there were 6 and 4 of them, so who knows how the rules will change in the future. Now, a little bit about the scores. In gymnastics, there is a grade of D and E. The grade D is an assessment of the difficulty. In the rhythmic gymnastics, the assessment includes the difficulty of the body, DB. In other words, the elements that the gymnast perform includes jumps, balances, and the rotations. All elements for rhythmic gymnastics are fixed in the rules, but its cost. The costs and variation also varies depending on the year, most often with the Olympics cycles. But it happens that something is changed in the rules earlier. Jumps or leaps, I think it's clear, is when a gymnast jumps. Balance is a static element, either on a releve or on the full foot. And rotation is a turn or period, when the gymnast performs rotational movements around herself. Dance track, C, when the gymnast performs a series of dance movements for 8 seconds. Dynamic elements with the rotation or masteries is P, and the difficulty of the apparatus. This includes everything else that the gymnast does with the apparatus. In group exercise, there is also a cooperation. This is the joint work of the gymnasts when each enters into interaction with one or more apparatus or partners. An element in gymnastics is most often called the difficulty of the body, but recently this concept has been slightly blurred, and to work with an apparatus or an interesting skill can also be called an element. Rating E, or performance evaluation. It takes into account the deduction for artistic and technical errors. Artistic errors includes errors related to the composition of the exercise, getting into the beat and the accent of the music, a variety of movements, and in general everything visually beautiful is evaluated here. There are a lot of criteria and they are all fixed in the rules. Technical errors or discounts are also fixed in rules. For instance, when a girl came off the element, fell, lost the apparatus, made something uncarefully, and so on. We discussed some of these mistakes in the video Top 10 Mistakes in Gymnastics, you can watch that the video also turn out to be useful. A discount, an error, or a deduction are in fact all synonyms in gymnastics. This is something that can be deducted. This includes artistics or technical mistakes. The difficulty in gymnastics is how many points a gymnast has scored or can score for an element or for an apparatus. Well, little important things. In rhythmic gymnastics, the costume in which the gymnast performs is called a leotard. In Russian, it is called a simsuit. This is a historically established term since at the founding of the gymnastics, they performed in leotards, also called simsuit. Now it looks more like a dress or a suit, but earlier it was all minimalistic. There is a video on the channel about the history and evolution of the leotards, so you can also watch it. An abbreviation WA. It occurs in young athletes, meaning an exercise without an apparatus. It's when a gymnast performs on a carpet without an apparatus in her hands. An important point about the word clubs. There is a word clubs, which means a weapon, and also in gymnastics there is a word clubs. Well, a little more slang that I can use and which may not be understood. Make a blunder means made a mistake or lost an apparatus. Well, that seems to be all. I'm sure I didn't tell you everything, but you know what to do. Write in the comments if there are a lot of words. I will do the second part. Well, I hope this video was useful for you. Write in the comments the words whose meaning you learned for the first time, or maybe you already knew everything. It will be interesting to read how well you understand slang. Well, I'll see you in the next video. Remember that I love you all very much, and bye bye!